In this episode of Cobb TV, we are going to talk about the magic of Ringo Starr's drumming on the song Get Back. Yes, and recently Peter Jackson just released the movie Get Back, so we're going to talk about the titular song. I have also seen the original Let It Be. I had a bootleg of that at one point, so I was always really inspired by Ringo's drumming in that era in which they recorded Let It Be and Abbey Road, kind of in the same time frame, and he had a really specific and distinguishable style, and Get Back is no exception to that. What we have is a military style groove, but he plays it the way Ringo plays it. He plays it a lot different than most people. So let's talk about that groove. It's just a simple rhythm. A lot of people refer to that as a triple stroke roll in the rudiment language. A triple stroke roll is ticka-ta-ticka-ta-ticka-ta. Usually you're going right, left, right, or alternating right, left, right to left, right, left. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. And that's how a rudimental drummer might play it. But Ringo plays it right, right, left, right, right, left, right, right, left. I've also seen people play it left, left, right, left, left, right, left, left, right. But again, that's not the way Ringo does it. And even Paul McCartney's drummer, Abe, I've seen him play it like a train beat. That's just a steady stream of 16th notes, but accenting it in a different way. The way Ringo plays it, right, right, left, right, right, left, right, right, left. And that's the main groove. In order to get the sound on the snare, we have to put a tea towel on the snare drum. That's what Ringo did during those recording sessions. And if you don't have a tea towel, a bandana will work. I use my Foo Fighters bandana. Or you can put a t-shirt on the snare drum. Now let's talk about how to actually play the groove. So it's fours, or four on the floor on the kick drum. And then you're going to add the snare drum with your left hand playing the same exact notes as the kick drum. And then add in the 16th notes with the right hand, and a 1, and a 2, and a 3, and a 4, and a 1, and a 2, and a 3, and a 4. But try to play them as grace notes. You don't have to necessarily play them like super, super quiet ghost notes, but they're definitely not played as loud as what your left hand is doing. And the thing about playing it with this specific sticking pattern is that Ringo does all of the crashing on the ride cymbal, which makes sense with the way that he's playing the groove. And when we crash on the ride cymbal, whenever we're playing the downbeat accents that the band is playing, we are playing the snare, the crash, or the ride, I mean, and the kick drum all at the same time. And then when we play the offbeats, we are playing just the kick drum and the ride cymbal as a crash. During the keyboard solo and kind of the outro interlude, we're playing again fours on the snare and the kick drum, but we're playing eighth notes on the floor tom. And now lastly, let's talk about that fill after the false ending. We have about two measures of just pause, of tacit, and on the second measure, starting on beat three, we have a rhythm that goes da-da-da-da-da. Now, the main one that I hear is tom, snare, snare, tom, tom. But Ringo's played a few different variations throughout the process of recording this song, and in the different live versions, they played Get Back three different times on the rooftop. And again, it doesn't matter what variation you choose, just as long as you get the rhythm right. And if you want to do it in the style of Ringo, start that pattern with your left hand. Hopefully you enjoyed this informative video on how to play Get Back by the Beatles. Ringo Starr is definitely a style of drumming now. I watched a video actually of how Vanessa Carlton wrote and recorded A Thousand Miles, and the producer that worked with her on that track, when he's referring to the recording, there's a part in the drumming that he even refers to as Ringo Starr, which I thought was super interesting. That was a neat little tidbit. Please like and consider subscribing for more awesome musical content. And I'd just like to say thank you on behalf of the group, and I hope we pass the audition.